Let's consider how many total values ANSYS needs to calculate by solving the mathematical model numerically. And that brings us to the idea of the total number of degrees of freedom. Let me go to mechanical, okay, and select translate, and I'll move the this up. And at this node, okay, we saw that if we call that node 1, so we want how that point on the midline is going to move in the y direction, and that is a y direction, and also how the cross section is going to rotate, and the rotation is going to be about z, so z is going to be perpendicular to the screen, so that's at node 1. Similarly, at node 2, we want to know how that point moves in the y direction and the corresponding rotation, and similarly over here at node 3. So you would think that there are, you know, a total of 6 parameters that ANSYS needs to calculate. That's what we saw in pre-analysis. It turns out ANSYS has a more general formulation where it, you know, it accounts for the fact that you could have a force in the x direction, and so this point on the midline could also move in the x direction. Okay, you would call that the move, you know, what is the displacement in the x direction at the midline at node 1. It'll also account for the fact that that point can move in the z direction, and that would happen if you had a force in the z direction. Okay, we were ignoring all of these forces to keep the math, you know, the math kind of tractable so that we can understand the big ideas. And then you can extend it, and that's what ANSYS, you know, the ANSYS implementation has done. And similarly, you can have the cross-section rotate not only in the z direction, but also in the y direction, okay? So there are, and then you can also have the cross-section rotate about the x-axis. So this is an out-of-plane rotation. This is like a rotation that will be caused by a torsional, by torsion. So in addition to the one displacement and one rotation we have at each node, ANSYS calculates, you know, 2 additional displacements and 2 additional rotations. And we will make sure that all these, you know, at every node, these additional ones are set to 0 because they're not important for our problem. So you have 6 degrees, what you would call 6 degrees of freedom at that node, similarly 6 degrees of freedom at that node, and 6 degrees of freedom at that node. So you would say total degrees of freedom is 18, okay, of which we are only interested in 2 of these at each node. Okay, so that completes the meshing, and let's move on to finishing up the definition of the mathematical model so that we can get ANSYS to solve it for us.